We have a star-studded cast, not only of actors, but musicians as well. And it was written by one of our very own, Tatiana King. And she's pretty famous for writing her plays. She's actually done all the plays so far for Warwick Church. It's called A Story to Tell. And even though it's set in Bible times, there's going to be a lot of modern aspects as well. We kind of mix the modern with the old. And so I hope that you are blessed by this today. And I hope that you will be able to take the story you hear today and tell it to someone else. Because that is the whole point of the Christmas season. It's not just, oh, presents and Christmas trees, but there's a story behind there, and there's a story that needs to be told about Jesus Christ the Savior. So, without further ado, I give you a story to tell.
I do not have time for this. The line at Joppa Java's was literally stressed at Capernaum, and you know that if Miss Jacobs doesn't have her latte by 9, she'll have my head.
I don't know why you put up with her nonsense.
Because I have a plan. 5 years of writing fluff pieces, and Miss Jacobs will discover my hidden talents, and I'll get my own column. Mock me all you want, but my plan will work.
Hate to break it to you, Augusta, but you'll have been here 5 years in like 2 weeks, and the closest your articles have gotten to Jacobs is her trash can.
Thanks for all the support. I feel the love.
Oh, I'm here anytime. That's your cue.
Thank you. Good morning, ma'am. Here's your latte, ma'am. How are you today?
Just hold that thought. Yes. Mm-hmm. Yes. Yes. Yes, yes. I want it exactly like that. Exactly like that. Yes, please. Okay. Okay. Ugh. Amateurs.
Make sure that Benjamin, yes, finishes sports piece, and that Rebecca confirmed the interview with Pilot for the census, and cancel my 11 o'clock because we are behind on the deadline and I just don't have time for this today.
Okay. And, well,
yes?
I was wondering if I could cover the Zillet riots that have been happening lately. I wrote a cover story just outlining the highlights. I'm missing interviews, but if you would just take a look at what I...
Jeremiah is covering the Zillet riots.
But ma'am, Jeremiah doesn't have my background in political science.
Excuse me?
I'm sorry, ma'am. I didn't mean to be disrespectful, ma'am, but I've been writing fluff pieces for this newspaper for 5 years. I mean, I'm going crazy here. Who cares if the Pharisees change their robes from cream to eggshell? I mean, a girl can only take so much. All I'm asking for is a chance. Please, let me prove to you that I'm a real journalist. Okay, fine. Please, ma'am, I just need wait, what?
I said... Okay.
Thank you!
Okay, personal space.
I'm sorry, ma'am.
Okay. There are rumors about a pregnant virgin in Nazareth. I want the inside scoop.
Wait, what now?
Is this thing on? I said a pregnant girl... in Nazareth, she is a virgin, a girl who is pregnant and still a virgin.
Oh, okay, yes, ma'am. I heard that, ma'am, but how is that possible?
Well, apparently there's a couple of eyewitnesses. I think this has something to it.
Are you sure I just can't cover the riots?
Well, if this story is way too big to you, I can just give it to Jeremiah.
No, I can do this, ma'am, I can do this.
Okay, well then I want a rough copy on my desk by Friday.
Yes, ma'am.
So what happened?
I got a story.
You got a story?
Yeah.
Why don't you sound excited?
Because it's not even close to what I wanted.
Well, beggars can't be choosers. What's the story?
Some pregnant virgin in Nazareth.
Wait, what? Let me see that.
I mean, how can someone be pregnant and a virgin? It's against the laws of nature.
I don't know, Dasa. There are a few eyewitnesses to this. There could be something to it.
Please, a pregnant virgin? Where's the logic in that? I mean, my first big break is over before it even started.
Come on, be happy. You got a story.
I got a story.
No, more excitement. You got a story.
Fine. I got a story.
Yeah. Hadassah?
Miss Jacobs?
Holy Father, you have to carry yours. I am waiting in the silent prayer. I am frightened by the Lord.
Alright, first interview, let's see. Elizabeth, elderly cousin of our mysteriously pregnant virgin.
Be careful, kids.
Oh, are these your grandchildren?
Oh, no, unfortunately, I do not have any children of my own.
Oh, I'm so sorry, I shouldn't have assumed. Let me start from the beginning. Okay, hi, I'm Hadassah from the Galley Gazette.
It's alright, don't worry about me, child. I had almost given up hope, but then the angel came and told my husband that we would have a son.
But how? You're so old.
Old? old. It's all right, I know. But be careful with those doubts. I had almost given up hope, but now we're going to have a son.
Oh wow, and who told you that?
The angel of the Lord came and told my husband.
An angel? Are you sure it wasn't like a mirage or something?
Oh no, definitely not. Be careful with those doubts. That got my poor Zacharias in trouble. The angel got upset at him. He said, "I am Gabriel. I stand at the door in the presence of God. God sent me to tell you the good news, but because you did not believe, you will not be able to speak until the day this happens. Everything will come to pass at the right time."
Wow, that truly is incredible.
Yes. Oh, here he is. Oh, thank you. He is asking you if you would like some.
Oh, no, no, thank you. Is it a little, you know, hard having him like this?
Oh, no, child. But he is telling you that he can hear just fine.
Oh, I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry.
Oh, he's kicking. Yes, not, no, my love, not as strong as when Mary came.
Oh, Mary, your cousin.
Oh, I see you've done your research.
Yeah, well, it's not every day that a pregnant virgin comes around town.
Well, it is true. When Mary came, I did not know that she was pregnant. She wasn't showing yet. But as soon as she came and greeted me, my baby leapt for joy inside of me. I told her, "Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the child that you bear."
Wow, that is, no, 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 unbelievable.
Believe it or not, that is how it happened. The prophets predicted it too. Isaiah said, "And the virgin shall conceive a son, and will call him Emmanuel." If you don't believe me, you can go to the palace and ask Herod's priest. He knows all about the birth of the promised Redeemer.
Wait. This baby is not only supposed to be born to a virgin, but is the Messiah?
Yes, and our little one will pave the way for him.
Okay, all right, yeah, okay. Oh, wow, this story is getting crazier by the minute. Miss Jacob is gonna think I've lost it. Okay, thanks for the tip. Thank you so much, thank you. Oh, and also, good luck with your baby, and good luck with the never mind. Okay, bye-bye.
Thank you.
why I hate Jerusalem. It's too big and too crowded. Hey, I'm walking here. How am I gonna find the palace in this mess? Excuse me, do you think you could show me where the... Okay, rude. Pardon me, can you point me in the direction? Okay, disrespectful. Pardon me, can you tell me where the... Rude and disrespectful. That I need to be headed. Excuse me. Pardon me. Get to step in, people!
Hakeem! You better be right about this prophecy! You'd be ashamed to walk all this way for nothing!
Revive. What am I ever wrong?
Remember that time? Enough with the arguing. You two have been going on like this, like an old married couple since we left Persia. Plus, it looks like we have company. Hello, my dear. My name is Samir. This is my friend Rahman, like the news. And...
Hakeem.
And you are?
Hi, I'm Hadassah. I'm a reporter from the Galley Gazette.
A reporter? You can be young to be a reporter.
Oh, hush.
So, what are you writing about?
Well, I'm trying to get the inside scoop on a girl from around here that's pregnant and claims to be a virgin.
Ha! So you're looking for the promised king as well? Have you been reading the writings of what was his Hebrew name? Daniel! Have you been studying the prophecies of Daniel? Have you seen the star?
Whoa. Slow your roll there, wise guy. I am not even sure this woman and her baby even exist. I'm just following my leads. Not some... How did that star go through?
Oh, that? We've been following that for months.
It shines in the day. It shines at night. The brightest thing in the sky. Nothing like you ever...
How did you know about this star?
Well, one day, I came across some old copies of the writing of Daniel, and there it was, clear as day, a king was to be born.
Oh, and this king is supposed to come from that virgin?
Exactly.
Oh, this is insane. So, where are y'all headed from here?
Harris Place.
Where that to?
Oh, yeah, down Angel Street, like the fish and kings.
Oh, no. That's Herod's Palace.
Herod's Palace, okay. That's right.
What a coincidence. I'm actually heading in the same direction. Can I tag along?
I don't see why not. We could always have somebody to carry our bags. Come along.
Good afternoon, distinguished sirs. King Herod will be with you in just a moment.
Wow, this place is nice.
And you are?
Oh. Hi, I'm Hadassah, Galley Gazette.
A reporter? No. King Herod doesn't do interviews. We already sponsor the newspaper. Isn't that enough? Right this way, sirs. You stay here.
This sucks.
Psst. Hey, you.
Who, me?
Yes, you. Come with me. I can get you into the throne room.
Oh, thank you so much. You're a lifesaver.
Right over here.
Thank you.
Presenting Lord Hakim, Rahman, and Samir from the distant lands of the Medes and Persians.
Enough, enough, enough with all of this pomp and circumstance. Gentlemen, what brings you to my humble kingdom and my palace?
A king, my liege.
A king? I hope you mean me.
No, my lord. We come in seeking a king spoken about in the scriptures. A king of the Jews, a messiah for all.
You see, we don't know the exact location of this child. We will hope to use your library to look at the scriptures.
No, no need. Priest!
Yes, sir, your king. Your king, sir. Your.
Please tell these fine gentlemen where they may find this messiah your writings speak about.
Of course, King Herod, I know it by heart. But you, Micah, the prophet, has says, but out of her, Bethlehem, Ephrathah, shall come forth in the least of these, out of Judah, a ruler in Israel, the one, and he. Let me answer your question, sir. The ruler that's coming out of is from Bethlehem.
Bethlehem! I knew we'd find him. Thank you, my lord.
Yes, King, sir.
We are one step closer.
Thank you, King, sir.
I am not a lord. Gentlemen, before you go, when you find this child, please send me his exact location so I may worship him.
Of course, my lord.
Lord? I am not a lord. I am a king, and I am still king. I tell you what we must do. We must find this little brat and kill him. I don't care if we have to kill every little boy in Bethlehem. I will not share my throne. Who's that? Guards, get her!
Oh, this baby better exist. This is well above my pay grade.
Did you know that your baby boy would one day walk on water? Mary, did you know your baby boy would save our sons and daughters? Did you know that your baby boy has come to make you new? That sleeping child you're holding is the great. Did you know that your baby boy will give sight to a blind man? Mary, did you know that your baby boy calm a storm with his hand. Did you know that your baby boy has walked where angels trod? When you kiss your little baby, you kiss the face of God. Oh Mary, did you know? The blind will see, the deaf will hear, the dead will live again. The lame will leap, the dumb will speak the praises of the Lamb. Mary, did you know that your baby boy is Lord of all creation? Mary, did you know that your baby boy will sit and rule the nations? Did you know?
Skip leg day. Oh, hello there.
You okay there, miss?
Me? Yes. I'm good. I'm Adassa. Galley Gazette. I'm just out for a run.
Well, nice to meet you, Adassa. You can take a breather. They're just here studying the prophecies of the Messiah in Isaiah.
Not you guys, too. Why is everyone up in arms about this baby? First the old woman, and then the rich guys, and now the king, and now you guys. What is the big deal?
Do not be afraid, for behold, I bring you good tidings of joy, which will be for all people. For there is a word to you these days, in the city of David, a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign to you. You will find a babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger.
As a congregation, we're going to sing together the angels we have heard on high.
Messiah's here.
The baby? How can you be so sure?
How can I be sure? Did you not see the angels and hear their message?
The facts
were right there in front of your face. For a reporter, you can't seem to tell the true story when you see one in front of your face.
I know. I don't know. Everyone's been talking about the Messiah coming for ages, but not like this. Not coming as a baby, not born to a virgin, not strangers knowing more about his birth than his own people. Not his own people trying to kill him. I'm so confused. I don't... The angels coming to old people and then smelly shepherds? Oh, sorry, no offense.
None taken. It's part of the job. But you're right. It's not happening like people imagine, because that's not how the Bible foretold. It says right here in Isaiah that no beauty or majesty would attract us to him, and nothing in his appearance that we should desire him. He would be despised and rejected by mankind, a man of suffering and familiar with pain, like one from whom people would hide their faces. The scriptures speak plainly that the Savior would not come like a king, but more like a servant. So, Miss Reporter, are you ready to see him?
You know, I think I'm finally ready.
Good. Come on, boys, let's head out.
Boy, I really need to get to the gym. Those guys, I lost them. They move so fast. I just need to take a breather.
Whew. What do you mean you're having room?
Did you have a reservation?
Reservation? She's the Hamilton princess. Reservation?
No reservation, no room. Okay, bye.
I hope you know this is the last time I'm coming to this place. You lost a customer for life.
Does it look like I care?
Hey, what's going on around here?
He was trying to fight me.
What? No. He wasn't trying to fight him. He was just trying to get a room.
And you are?
Hi, I'm Hadassah, Galley Gazette.
Okay, well, Miss Reporter, take my statement. Everybody is around here trying to find a room. And I was like, no reservation, no room. But, like, he was persistent. King David?
What my beautiful wife is trying to say is that we are very full, you know? With the census going on and all, we just had to give the last space to a pregnant girl and her husband.
Mm-hmm. Her husband was like around here and I was like, I told him the same thing I told him. It was that there was no room, there was no reservation, but we just gave it to him.
Oh dear. Well, you know, I suggested in the kitchen by the fireplace.
The kitchen? Of all places, that is unsanitary, which is why I suggested the stable.
The stable? And that was better?
Well, they took it, didn't they? And the girl said thank you, which is more than what I get from you.
Really? Really? What is it that you do around here anyway that I can thank you for? Poor girl, she'll probably have to put her baby in the manger.
A manger! That's exactly what the angel said! Can you tell me where the stable is?
That way.
Thank you so much! Bye-bye!
Wait, aren't you gonna take my picture for the paper?
Come on.
Fred?
Come on.
Songs have it all wrong. It wasn't silent on that night, but as the angels' praises rang clear, all their melodies and harmonies fell on deaf ears. All of heaven was on the edge of their seats, anticipating a Lord so mild and meek. People had been waiting so long for a Savior to come, but they never knew on that dark, cold night came God's only Son. It wasn't silent on that night as Mary and Joseph traveled to David's city, over hills and through the valleys, only to end up in a stable where Mary's cries rang through the alleys. There was no room at the inn, so they were stuck with the cattle, with the dirt and the hay, with no crib or a pillow for his head to lay. It wasn't silent on that night. Listen to the angels sing. But the only ones that heard were shepherds, but they paid respect to their king. Our Savior was used to consistent celestial praise, but he came down instead in human form to a place where animals graze. It wasn't silent on that night as the fulfillment of prophecy came down, but he left his throne to be amongst his children. But this tale of a virgin and husband with callous hands and angels and foreigners that came across the sand, it doesn't end at Christmas. It doesn't end today. Listen to what I have to say. God came for us. He gave us his sacrifice so that we would not be lost in sin and that we would have true life. So please remember throughout this holiday season that it's not the gifts and it's not receiving. He is the ultimate reason.
Sorry we lost you back there. We were in a bit of a hurry when we heard that the promised one was here. It was exactly like the angel said. Here he is, wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying
in a manger.
Wow. The mightiest of kings, born in the lowest of places, God in the flesh. We have been reading the passages of the wise prophets that spoke of a king, and we saw the star and knew that it was a sign of his promise. We have come to worship him. We have bought gifts, gold, for the King of Kings. Frankincense for the priests of the people. And myrrh to honor his sacrifice.
Wow, this is incredible. The star, the miracle, the prophecies, the gifts.
Do you have enough for your story yet?
Well, I have more than enough. I mean, I couldn't believe it at first. I wouldn't believe it at first. But now, here it is right before my eyes. A baby. A miracle. Born in a manger.
I'm just glad that if someone is going to tell the story, that'll be the truth. And the people deserve to hear the truth.
I just can't believe we're the only ones here.
Well, all the signs were there, but only a few were looking for the truth.
This is incredible. Everyone has to hear this. I have to tell this news. Finally, we will have some good news. That's what I'll call it. The good news.
That sounds perfect.
You are the good news. I mean, it's a really strange way to change the world, but it's all a part of God's plan.
Where this road had taken him, 'cause never in a million lives would he have dreamed of Bethlehem. Standing in the manger, he saw with his own eyes the message of the angel come alive. And Joseph said, "Why me? I'm just a simple man of trade. Why him? With all the rulers in the world. Why here? Inside this stable filled with hay. Why her? She's just an ordinary girl. Now I'm not one to second guess what angels have to say, but this is such a strange way to save the world. To save the world. To think of how it could have been if Jesus had come as he deserved. There would have been no Bethlehem, no lowly shepherds at his birth. But Joseph knew the reason love had to reach so far. And as he held the Savior in his arms, he must have thought, "Why me? I'm just a simple man of trade. Why him? With all the rulers in the world. And why here? Inside this stable filled with hay. Why her? She's just an ordinary girl. Now I'm not one to second guess what angels have to say, but this is such a strange way to save the world.
to second guess what angels have to say. But this is such a strange way to save the world. This is such a strange way to save the world. This is such a strange way to save the world.
I'll tell you the whole story, or you can read it when I make the front page.
That confident?
You bet I am. Now, shh. I'm getting into the zone.
Thank you.
Hadassah!
Don't forget this.
Thank you.
And good luck.
Yes, ma'am?
Thank you. Your article. It's brilliant, really. It's riveting, it's fact-checked, and it's amazing how a story, you know, this small rumor about a young girl turns out to be the truth about the Messiah. But, I'm sorry, I have to cut it.
Wait, what?
Herod's Palace is a big sponsor of the Galilee Gazette, and he's just not happy about the thought of another king, so it's cut.
No, of course he's not. He literally had me chased out of the palace. But it's our job to tell the news. This is a story. It's an incredible story that we have to tell. It's our job to tell the truth, the good news.
And it's my job to keep my job, okay? So the story is cut.
But.
It's cut, period. No buts. Back to your desk, please. Yes, no. Those tears don't work on me. Back to your desk. What happened?
She cut the story.
You're kidding.
I wish I was. It could have been the greatest story ever told. The willingness of a young girl to face public ridicule. The bravery of a husband to trust the message of an angel. The irony that lowly shepherds were the only ones waiting for the Son of God. The faith of foreigners that are not of our land or our religion, but still humbled themselves before the King of Kings. It's changed my life. It could have changed the lives of others. At first, it was just about making the front page, but now, I just want to make a difference. Now who will I tell?
I'm sorry, Tessa. But a story like that won't stay secret forever. It's okay.
Auntie Dasa! Auntie Dasa!
Oh, there's my favorite nephew. Leah, have you met my nephew, Matthew?
Nice to meet you, Matthew.
Nice to meet you, Miss Leah.
Matthew, where's Mommy?
She's downstairs waiting. What's wrong, Auntie? You look like you're crying.
It's just that I worked really hard on a really good story, and now it's not going to be published.
Oh, no. That's okay, Auntie. When I grow up, I'm going to be a writer, and I'll write your story.
You know what? That's a great idea. That makes me feel a lot better. And you know what, Matthew? I think you could write a whole book about it.
Tell me the story, Auntie.
Well, I don't want to keep your mom waiting, but I will tell you a little bit of the story right now. Come sit here. This is how the birth of Jesus, the Messiah, came about. His mother Mary was engaged to be married to Joseph. But before they got married, she was found to be pregnant through the Holy Spirit.
Thank you.
Set the night wind to the little lamb. Do you see what I see? Way up in the sky, little lamb. Do you see what I see? A star, a star. A tail as big as a kite, with a tail as big as a kite. Said the little lamb to the shepherd boy, do you hear what I shepherd boy, do you hear what I hear? A song, high above the trees, with a voice as big as the sea, with a voice as big as the sea. Said the shepherd boy to the mighty king, do you know what I know? In your palace warm, mighty king, do you know what I know? A child shivers in the cold. Bring him silver and gold. Let us bring him silver and gold.
I'm going to ask Tatiana. Tatiana, where are you? Folks, we are blessed. Amen. 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 Get over here. We are blessed to have this wonderful family and all of you and all of our actors and people up there with the communications and the internet and video camera people. We are blessed here at Warwick. Can we give the Lord a hand for everybody? Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you. As we come to a close, this is an opportunity that we have to think about the following. I know that Jesus was not born on December 25th. Is that all right? But he was born. He was born. God came down. and you could study all of the faiths of all of the world, and one thing is for certain, there is only one faith where God came for sinful human beings. And this is your opportunity. The play that was so wonderfully done, it actually was almost redone, and it shows the maturity, the spiritual maturity a child has undergone in working in a mission field. It shows it. It's exquisitely presented. And it's your opportunity and mine right now to make a decision. Inside your bulletin, you'll see a card. It'll be similar to this. I'm going to kindly ask you to please pull it out. Please pull it out. Because this play would mean nothing if you just go away right now without an opportunity to make a decision. The reporter found a story. She called it the good news. The Messiah came. There was an editor that refused to run the news report. Let's not make the same mistake. Whatever it is your decision is, here at Warwick, we want to help you. We want to help you to get to know the God that came in human form, allowed himself to be born in a manger, which is nothing more than a cave, allowed himself to be laid down on the same wood that he would one day carry on his shoulder and be nailed to, and be wrapped as a baby in swaddling clothes, which is a death burial wrap. That same child is one day going to come again. And he's coming now no more as a child. He's coming as a full-grown adult. As a matter of fact, the Bible says he's coming as King of Kings and Lord of Lords. For every single one of us who make a decision for Jesus. Maybe the reason that you came here today was to see a play, but maybe the Holy Spirit touched your heart and you know you would like to make a decision for Christ. I'm going to pray for you. I'm going to ask every head to be bowed, every eye to be closed. As I pray for that individual who is making a decision right now, Father God, I pray for that individual who came today only to watch a play, but they were touched today. They felt the prompting of your Holy Spirit. They know the messages, they have heard the stories, and today they are ready to make a decision. Father God, I pray for that man, that woman, that son, that daughter, that today would like to make a decision to follow Jesus. Father God, I pray for that somebody's son, for somebody's daughter, whose mother or father has been praying for them. Father God, I pray for that individual that you came to die for, that you long to save, that you want them to live with you for eternity. Father God, I pray that that person fill out that card today and then hand it to me today in Jesus' name. Amen.